alaikum
salam.
And that's not just in Islam, because when we say assalamu alaikum, we mean may God's peace be with you, because there's only one kind of peace, and that's the peace that comes from our Creator, from the Muslim perspective and the Abrahamic perspective. For those of you who are secular humanists, may peace be with you. All peace is great peace. I can't believe that I'm here today with Reverend Blackman, Reverend Forbes, and the Reverend Barber. I'm just astounded. I'm here today to testify about the phenomenon of Islamophobia.
Fear of Muslims and Islam is driving our nation's foreign policy, which is deeply embedded in war profiteering, an unending war to the tune already of $7 trillion. That's $7 trillion that could have paved our roads, that could have paid for home health care workers, that could have paid for education, that could have paid our economy, that could have paid for the education system that we need.
Refugees being lured in Iraq
job, and it's very difficult to start your life from scratch in a place that you don't know with people you've never seen before. I'm very fortunate to be here while many Syrians are living with no shelters, with no roof over their heads. Syria is the home of many civilizations, and actually Damascus, where I'm from, is the oldest continuously inhabited city in the world. Now in the world, as Sister Julia mentioned, there are 65 million refugees who had to leave their countries and start their lives from scratch. Living here in America, I can feel that to some people, I'm worth. My value as a human is worth. And it's very tiring and exhausting to explain myself all the time and defend my position to all people and all